those of you who don't know me, I prepared something, by the way. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Ryan, and I've had the privilege of knowing Mr. Peter Hoder since high school. Yeah. Peter sat directly in front of me in our government class senior year. We never really talked that much, but there was this one day I'll never forget. Peter must have been eavesdropping on a conversation I was having with my wife, Liz, who was also in the class, when the subject of aviation came up. In that conversation, I mentioned that I was planning on being a pilot, what school I was planning on going to. But without hesitation, Peter turns around with that big grin of his and says, "Me too." Well, over the next few months, practically every conversation was about flight training or what college we were going to go to and so on. We both decided to do all of our training locally at the same flight school, and we never looked back. In a weird way, our friendship and competitive natures pushed us in trying to see who could get all of our licenses first. Peter ended up getting his pilot's license first, he won, which only pushed me harder to try to finish mine. After we both got our pilot's license, we started building up our time, which, you know, that's what you do after you get your license, flying together all over the place. Needless to say, we spent a lot of time together. We flew together so much, especially to Key West, that I'm pretty sure that some of the people at the flight school would be surprised that it wasn't you and me getting married today. Well, one night in one of those college classes we took together, Peter told me that he was starting to hang out with this new girl. As I asked him some further questions, I could tell he was holding something back. He finally revealed that the new girl was in high school. Okay, you know, well, we were only in our first year of college, so I guess dating a senior in high school wasn't that uncommon. Oh, she's a sophomore. Okay. Melissa, I have to admit that, at the time, I advised Peter only as his good friend and amateur legal counsel that it might not be the best idea he'd ever had. Sure, it might be a little awkward not being able to get into bars and clubs for the first 3 years you guys dated, but what did I know? Here we are almost a decade later at this beautiful wedding. It has been amazing seeing Melissa go from a quiet, shy sophomore to the kind, giving, and beautiful bride that she is today. I know all of her friends will agree with me when I say that she is truly one of the most generous and selfless people you will ever meet. Aww. Peter, you have been such a good friend to me over the last decade. I can't thank you enough for all the memories and also for letting me be a part of Melissa and your special day. I want to thank James and Rose for hosting this amazing night. And also for Ben and Amy hosting an awesome rehearsal dinner last night. Thank you. As many of you know, Peter's job takes him all over the world for weeks on end. I can only imagine how difficult it must be to spend night after night in places like New York, Los Angeles, and Las Vegas. And London, Paris, Italy, Hawaii, Germany, Poland, South Africa, Brazil, Vancouver, and Switzerland. And that's just since June. But seriously, as many of us in this room know, it takes a special type of love, commitment, and trust to make this type of lifestyle work. You both are very lucky to have each other as best friends and now partners in life. So if everyone will raise their glasses, here's to a lifetime of love, happiness, and adventures. And Peter, may Melissa always be your guiding light home. Cheers. Oh.